Warframe, a game I'm sure we have all had both good memories and bad experiences with. From taking down Captain Shitfazer himself, or getting your hands on the weapon or Warframe you have wanted for a long time. To butting your head against a wall of bad RNG, when all you want is 5 fucking Orokin cell, resulting in sitting by the campfire on Hydran and other farming locations bored out of your mind. We have all had our own impressions and experiences with the game, but today I'm here to tell you all about minutes since I first picked it up early in 2013. So sit your little ass down and listen up. I had kept an eye on the development of Warframe, but after Dark Sector was released to mediocre reception from critics and fans, I wasn't 100% sure I wanted to give their new title a go. But eventually I said what the hell and decided to give it a shot. Because why not, right? After all, it was a free-to-play game, and they had even had an astounding price of $250 for the top-tier Founder Pack, so it must be good, right? Already during the first impressions of the game, I instantly fell in love. The gameplay was astounding, and the overall diversity was a fresh taste on MMO gaming. Considering when it was released, Warframe was definitely a game well ahead of its time. Even with its sizable lack of content at the time, it was excusable, as all games have to start from somewhere, and from the looks of it, Warframe had the foundation to turn into something great. Even with none of the big publishers sharing developer Digital Extremes' faith in their new IP, predicting its failure to fit with the current gaming trends of the day. But, enough of that. We all know how that ends up. It's time to go over my personal experiences with the game. I purchased the $250 Founder Pack for Warframe after about 20 hours of gameplay, realizing this was a game I'd be playing for years to come, and I was right. Backed by the strongly positive first impressions I had with the game as mentioned earlier. Gameplay immediately grabbed my attention and got me hooked. Through its high fluidity and opportunity to traverse the tile sets with almost complete freedom. Despite having its fair share of clunky aspects, but that was later fixed with movement patches and updates, adding even more fluidity and map freedom, but I digress. Digital Extremes effectively and consistently ironed them out until we got the well-oiled machinery Warframe is today. As years passed, I decided around the beginning of 2017 to take a break from Warframe for a couple of months. It was a decision I made primarily due to the sheer fact I had simply experienced everything the game had to offer. I had maxed every item, completed all quests and had everything obtainable in the game. Down to every last mod and exclusive item. So I set off to experience other games that previously had been held off in favor of Warframe. In hopes that my current burnout on the game wouldn't lead me to hate Warframe for everything that it is. And let's be honest, all true Warframe fans hate the game and love it, it's just that type of relationship. I made my eventual return to the game around late summer of 2017, seeing as a lot of new content had released. As I sat down, I thought to myself, let's check out what's new on old Warframe today, and proceeded to download the mountain of updates that were waiting me until I finally arrived at the login screen. I typed in my login information like I always do, but to my surprise this time I got login failed. At first I thought, okay, I probably mistyped the shit. Fast forward to 10 attempts later with failed logins, and I checked everything like caps lock, but to no avail. At this point I headed to their website to do a quick password reset, and upon entering my email to get a reset link, the site promptly replied that it could not find any account associated with that email. By now I was thinking, what the actual fuck is going on? So I got in contact with their support and explained my situation. That something had happened to my account and that I couldn't log in nor get a password reset. The only response they had was that no email was associated with that account, which is the exact same bullshit that the website told me. I promptly asked them to check again. I had even given them my username that was associated with my account, and they still gave me the same response. Only this time telling me that username never existed. But I had bank account withdrawals that proved otherwise, having purchased the Founders Pack and some Odds and Ends Platinum along the way. Eventually they stopped replying to me as I basically told them that they were wrong and pressured them on answers to where my account had gone. Seeing as this was my most played game, I was eager to just lose all that progress and money I had sunk into it. As time went by with no progress on retrieval of my old account, I knew if I emailed again they would give me the exact same bullshit answer. I lost hope and decided to create a new account. I did so because despite losing so much, I still loved the game itself and jumped back in, back at square one. But being me and who I am, after a couple of months I once again contacted their support about my lost account to see if anything had changed. And helpful as Warframe support is, they still came back to me with the same answers, and at that point it seemed my old account was lost forever. With that we wrap up the story about how I lost my founder account and years of progress. And the funny thing about it all, even if I got fucked over royally by their poor account handling, I still play the game and love it to this day. It's like a toxic relationship, where I stay with the game even if it consistently screws me over, and I hope that no one else will have to experience the same problems as I did, and instead are allowed to enjoy the game itself, to the fullest, because at the end of it Warframe is an incredible game that in many aspects break new ground, and challenge the norm in an industry that is dominated by poor decision making and consumer hostile policies. Well, that's the wrap up of this video. Feel free to check out our shitty Discord channel if you'd like to speak with me, or just want to socialize with the local special people.